Hello everybody. Today we are going to use balloons to make sculpture of hedgehog. Let's inflate brown balloon, leaving about 8-inch flat tail. From this balloon we're going to make the head, legs and belly of the hedgehog. Let's twist the first soft about thumbnail size bubble, lock both ends of the first bubble in one lock twist. We have made the nose. Also, there are a couple different ways to make the nose. We will talk about it later. Now let's twist the second about 2-inch long bubble. Now let's twist the third soft about 2-inch long bubble. Twist the fourth soft about 1-inch long bubble. Lock both ends of the fourth bubble in one lock twist. Then we twist the fifth soft about 2-inch long bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last three bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the head. Also keep in mind that I am always giving very approximately estimated size of all bubbles. Now let's twist the 6th and the 7th about 1-inch long bubbles. Lock both ends of the 7th bubble in one lock twist, we have made the front leg. Then we twist the 8th about 2-inch long bubble. Now we twist the 9th soft about 1-inch long bubble and lock both ends of the 9th bubble in one lock twist, we have made the rear leg. Twist the 10th and 11th about 1-inch long bubbles. Twist the 12th soft about 1-inch long bubble, lock both ends of the 12th bubble in one lock twist. Twist the 13th about 2-inch long bubble. Twist the 14th soft about 1-inch long bubble, lock both ends of the 14th bubble in one lock twist. Don't forget to hold the 10th and 11th bubbles, or they will untwist themselves. Let's twist the 15th about 1-inch long bubble. And then we have to lock both ends of the chain of the last 10 bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the head with legs and lower part of the body of our hedgehog. Now we can cut off the rest of the brown balloon. We can keep it and use it as a handle. I'm going to use it to make the belly and the tail. Now let's twist the 16th about maybe 3-inch long bubble. And then we have to lock the free end of the 16th brown bubble between the 10th and the 11th bubbles. The rest of the balloon is a tail. We can leave it as it is. I would rather make it shorter. Let's twist the 17th about 1-inch long bubble, cut off the rest of the balloon tie of the end. So again, we have made the lower part of the hedgehog body. Also, we can use this body to make a sculpture of turtle and some other animals as well. In this example, the 7th, the 9th, and the 12th and 14th bubbles represents the legs. To make the upper part of the hedgehog body, I'm going to inflate a gray color balloon leaving about 8-inch flat tail. Let's tie the nozzle of the gray balloon between the 10th and the 11th brown bubbles. In this example, I'm going to twist all gray bubbles of the same, about 1-inch size. Let's twist the first gray bubble. We have to lock the free end of the first gray bubble with one of the rear legs bubbles. Then we twist the chain of the next two gray bubbles. And we lock the free end of the third gray bubble with the front leg bubble. Then we twist the chain of the next two gray bubbles. We have to lock the free end of the fifth gray bubble with the fourth brown bubble. This way we are working around the sculpture to make the first row. Now let's twist the chain of the next two gray bubbles, lock the free end of the last gray bubble with the other front leg bubble. Twist the chain of the next two gray bubbles, lock the free end of the ninth gray bubble with the rear leg bubble. Then we twist the 10th gray bubble. And now we have to lock both ends of the chain of the first 10 gray bubbles in one lock twist. Actually, I lock the free end of the 10th gray bubble with the tail bubble. We have made the first row. Here's the bottom view, the side view, and the front view. Let's start the second row by twisting chain of 3 gray bubbles. And then we have to lock both ends of the chain of the last 7 gray bubbles in one lock twist. Now let's twist the chain of the next 2 gray bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 9 gray bubbles in one lock twist. After that we can twist the chain of the next 3 gray bubbles. We have to work our way back to the tail bubble. Let's lock both ends of the chain of the last 8 great bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the second row. Now let's make the third row. We have to twist the chain of the next 2 gray bubbles. Let's lock both ends of the chain of the last 6 gray bubbles in one lock twist. Then we're going to twist the chain of the next 2 gray bubbles. And now we have to lock the free end of the last, the 22nd gray bubble, with the last brown bubble, with the tail bubble. We can cut off the rest of the gray balloon. I would rather hide it between bubbles inside of the sculpture. Or you can leave it out and use it instead of the hedgehog tail. Let's fix all bubbles in proper positions. Here's a back view. Congratulations, we have made the hedgehog. Here's a side view. It is the front view, the top view. I'm going to use a permanent black marker to draw the eyes, the mouth, and the nose of our hedgehog. Also, we can draw the legs, or just leave it as it is. Congratulations again, we have made the hedgehog. We can make the gray bubbles of different size to give the body more round shape. In the following example, I want to use black bubble to make the nose using the tulip twist. Make black soft about 1 inch long bubble. Tie both ends of the black bubble in one knot. Cut off the rest of the black balloon, leaving about 2 inch long hand. Now let's twist the first brown about thumbnail size bubble. Lock the free end of first brown bubble with the black bubble, leaving at least 1 inch long black end between bubbles. Now let's force the first brown bubble about 2 inch inside of the brown balloon. Keep the black bubble outside of the brown balloon. There are different ways to make the tulip twist. We talk about it in many previously published instructions. You can find links on my website, fewdoit.com. Now let's twist the second about 2 inch long brown bubble. That's all, we have made the tulip twist. The rest of the hedgehog body we're going to work in exactly the same way as we did in previous example. In this example, I'm using the black balloon only to make the nose bubble. But if you want, you can use the black balloon also to make the leg bubbles. Here on the left side of your screen, you see an example of hedgehog body, as we have made it previously. As you see, there is only one important difference. We use black bubble to make the nose. Now I'm going to use a gray balloon to make the rest part of the sculpture. I'm going to make it in exactly the same way as we did the first time. Also, we can use different color balloons to make the hedgehog. Even in nature, the hedgehogs come in different colors. We can make bubbles of different size if you want. And we can connect bubbles in different order as well. The result is going to be pretty much the same. Here I'm already working the second row of the top part. It looks like we're almost done. Now let's fix all bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations again, we have made the hedgehog. Once again, I'm going to use a permanent black marker to draw the face of hedgehog. Eyes, mouth, that's it. Here's the side view, the front view, the top view. Alright, today we have made a couple of hedgehogs. A mommy hedgehog, a puppy hedgehog. We can make sculpture using smaller size bubbles to make a baby hedgehog. Then you will have a happy hedgehog family. That's about it for today. Have fun and happy twisting.